Thanks to her new friend, Quill had saved priceless grains from the hourglass. She raced to the door of the cottage she shared with her uncle, hoping once he saw her discovery, he'd lose himself in tales of its legend. Uncle Argus was watching the evening light dim when Quill burst through the front door of their cottage.
Uncle! Uncle, there's something you have to see!
Out past the bell again, he scolded. Quill, I've told you countless times.
I know, Quill replied, crestfallen. I didn't mean to worry you, but I found something strange and magical. Quill's hands trembled as she showed him the glass.
What is it?
She asked. A look of panic spilled over her uncle's stoic exterior.
Where did you find this?
Roared Uncle Argus. Quill had never seen her uncle so shaken.
Just west of the clearing, she explained.
And as soon as I picked it up, something started helping me. Uncle Argus followed her motion.
A reader. With you, here, right now? Quill, what you found is very powerful and very dangerous,
he said with great concern.
If I could take this burden from you, I would. But this reader has chosen. Even with the moon full and bright, I must go right away.
Quill pressed.
Where are you going? I can help. We can help.
No,
he snapped.
They'll find you and tear you apart. I have to go alone. It is for your own safety and for everyone here in the clearing.
His long, heartfelt hug told her he was heading for danger.
I'll be back before midnight. Until I return, I need your word you will not leave the clearing with that glass. Promise me, Quill.
I promise, she said reluctantly, wondering where her uncle was going so deep into the night.
Hey, kid! Kid! Wake up! Hey, kid, over here! I know where your uncle went. I can show you. You're twofold now. Very important. Bring that glass and your sidekick, too. We're going to need them.
Quill called out.
Hey! Starthing, wait!
Quill had never met a Starthing. In campfire stories, They often meddled in the lives of mortals. And when they appeared, mischief followed. Passage through the Eastern Gate was strictly forbidden. But despite her promise, Quill knew in her heart that Uncle Argus needed her. Quill demanded answers.
Starthing, you can't just barge in here with your riddles. Where is he? What do you know? The trouble your uncle's heading for is the kind only you and that silent giant up there can get him out of. This way, kid, urged the Starthing. And don't forget to tuck your ears in.
Thank you.
Just on the other side is the mire,
the Starling assured her.
There's a good chance your uncle's still there. Did you hear that?
The Starling seemed anxious.
I've ruffled enough leaves in these parts. I can't be seen with you. I'll catch up with you later. Just don't go and die on me. A whisper echoed through the trees.
Fought like someone who has stolen our champion's power.
A small, yet fantastical band of sprites emerged surrounding Quill.
I'm Veda, Rootseer of the Mire, and you have crossed into our domain.
She sized up Quill with a rueful gaze, then turned her attention upward.
I sense you there, too. I have not felt the presence of such a promising leader in some time.
A youthful warrior marched forward. Rootseer, I'm prepared to honor our great champion's legacy. Rodent, give us our glass. Quill stepped closer. Where is my uncle? If you've hurt him...
Silence!
Veda thundered back.
It was Argus who summoned us here, and now I see why. Young one, I'm afraid the trees hum of attack. Your uncle's been taken to the castle of your ancestors.
Quill's knees buckled as Veda continued.
Argus put himself at great risk calling for us. Your uncle once took a solemn oath to protect the glass of your fallen king. He is the only one left who knows where it's been hidden. The Arcane have long sought to wrest that knowledge from him. And you dare to cross into the mire with our glass? Sarfog will soon burn through this forest looking to tear you and your reader apart. Unless, of course, you find them first. Take these. Weapons made for the mighty champion who died so that your people could live.
Quill felt its otherworldly power course through her.
Find your uncle, Twofold. Before the serpent and its masters break him.
The warrior fumed.
Our glass with her? Rootseer, she's minuscule.
Come now. The reader has chosen its hero. We must let their story unfold.
Veda replied with a frost of finality and vanished into the shadows of the mire. Was Quill's favorite story. How Sir Argus fought beside the Sprite Champion to seal this temple from the Arcane and secured the survival of their kinds. Simply standing in their heroic footsteps felt like a great honor.
Thank you. Thank you. I Thank you. Guys, that's all for today, so subscribe to you know what the continuation of this game is.